We have three, is that right? Separate constituencies represented. I'm going to turn the floor to Avery.
Thank you. My name's Avery Doria. I'm sitting in for Robin Gross, who couldn't make the trip this time. She's the chair of the NCSG. NCSG is composed of two constituencies, MPOC and NCUC. We submitted a few questions, but then we're going to try and reorder the questions because of the conversation we just had. On the first question, though, that we had, preserving ICANN's commitment to the bottom-up community-led model for internet governance, after a bit of discussion in our policy committee and in our other meeting, we decided that it wasn't really worth asking that question. We felt that it wasn't specific enough, and we felt that it was too easy to answer, that the board would say, but of course we're committed to the bottom-up community-level model for internet governance. Next. So we've decided not to ask you that question, and I hope that's okay.
Next.
As I said, if you could go, though, to the next slide. Well, the first question we wanted to ask had to do with GNSO review and restructuring. And yes, GNSO review and restructuring. Clarification of board's direction so as to align near-term efforts of stakeholder groups and constituencies.
Wolfgang Kleinemeister, thank you, Avery. If a lot of new commercial partners join the GNSO supporting organizations and form their own constituencies, and you know how we can find ways, strategies, and policies to keep the balance between the commercial and the non-commercial groups in the right way so that the interests of the non-commercial stakeholder group remain adequately reflected in the whole structure. We have seen a number of proposals which are not yet, to my knowledge, not officially, to establish new registries in the contracting house. The Brent groups want to have probably a registry, the GEOs want to have an own registry. And our question is, you know, how do you anticipate, you know, what's going on, and do we have any plans, policies, or ideas, and how we want to react to this? Thank you.
Thank you. I don't actually remember exactly where the wording of these questions came from, but there is the point about aligning near-term efforts. I'd just like to speak to. We have, in NCUC, we've been putting a lot of time and effort since our last election, since December, into sort of trying to do a little organizational rebirthing and enhancement, building up our institutional capacity in a number of ways that I won't bore you with details, but an enormous amount of time and effort has been spent by volunteers in trying to strengthen the constituency and prepare to move forward more effectively. And now the next big task that we're looking at is the question of our bylaws, which are a bit dated and don't really correspond well to how we really function. And so in thinking about how and whether to embark on this, put a lot of time and effort into this, one thing that comes to our mind is, well, what exactly is the board thinking, though, about the future evolution of the stakeholder group and the larger structures that we're part of? Because it certainly wouldn't make a lot of sense for us to put a lot of time into rewriting bylaws if, in fact, some larger restructuring that would affect the constituency status were to take place. And we've been told of conversations with board members who have speculated about larger structural changes. And some of us would support that. If there's the possibility of some kind of change that could impact us, it would really help us to know that so that we don't go off and spend enormous amounts of time trying to build up something that would make go away or be changed from above. Thank you.
Thank you, Bill. I think part of that comes out of, we noticed with a certain amount of jealousy that it looked like the registrars with their new interest groups were actually getting to do some of the things that we had tried to do but been rejected on. So I think part of the question comes out of that as well. So we're wondering is whether it's Ray or someone else could possibly talk to us to this topic.
With regard to other things, Yes, I agree with what you just said about special interest groups and so forth. The problem that existed is, and you probably could have got away with this too, and is that there was no process in place to for anybody to amend the charters, wanting to establish a charter. So the decision that was made, whether or not it was the best decision or the correct decision, what the decision was, okay, we will approve this one amendment to this charter. However, if you will notice, there is also a question for comment, a stakeholder group charter amendment procedure. And I believe the comment period is open until sometime towards the end of August. With regard to what's going to happen with the future of ICANN, one of the, as was mentioned yesterday in the session on strategic planning, the board went through a similar type exercise for a day and a half, 2 days in Amsterdam during May. And a lot of the things that came up in discussion as far as looking at different impacts and so forth really boiled around to the GNSO and just the problem that, that was being raised here with regard to all these new things happening, which is the same thing. The constituency model as currently working is unworkable in the future for a number of reasons. It doesn't mean it has to go away. It just means that we have the fit structures that recognize that there can more likely be lots of constituencies. And so we have to figure out how we're going to accommodate that into the structure, not only to the structure, but also to the processes. Most importantly, the process of making policy and the process of governance. All I can say is that the board can't do this alone, and as far as the Structure Approvals Committee is concerned, we are not going to do this alone, and we intend to figure out ways of bringing people in. I know that you can see the effort from what Denise started with yesterday morning in the strategic planning process moving forward, that the community is not being left out of that process either. So it's really a matter of participating, and it's really a matter of going beyond where things are right now and thinking about realistically where is ICANN going to be in 5 years.
But I wanted to bring in one extra element to it and then pass it off to Bertrand. Is I think it's all well and good to be looking at the 3 to 5 year projection. But for example, there are some issues with this constituency model, et cetera, right now. For example, the letter that we just sent to the board about, you know, we went through a lot of effort to create a new constituency. You and I spent a lot of time talking about the birth of this new constituency. It's existed for 2 years now, and yet we can't get it a seat on NomCom like every other constituency in the GNSO. So 5 years is a good timetable for the future, but we do have current concerns, and so passing it off to Bertrand.
Clearly the topic of the evolution of the structural evolution of the organization is growing at the moment. And some of the discussions that took place early on in Toronto and afterwards show that there is a tension, or at least a discussion regarding, one, the scalability of the constituency-based model, as Bill has mentioned, and second, the evolution and the functioning of the workflow of the policy development process in general. And there were very interesting discussions in the last few days regarding the perceptions of whether the model functions or doesn't function. The discussion was growing. At this stage, the key question is, there is no particular vision on the board of how the evolution of the organization should be. Our main concern is that the discussion takes place. And in this regard, beyond the initiation of topics that have been made earlier on, and particularly the things that the Structural Improvement Committee has triggered and the reaction that it has gotten from the groups, one thing that is clear is that one of the committees that Felicia has announced on Monday, the balance that he has the intention to form, and particularly the one
that would be led by Glenn Simon-Herbeck, is likely to address the evolution of the multi-stakeholder model, and in particular, how we framed it, how we structure, how we evolve, and how it functions. This means that there will be an important discussion in the community, and it's not only feeding into the strategy plan thing, but it is something that will go faster, i.e., in terms of discussion, those panels are going to last about a year. So the key question is how the discussion around those panels are going to be organized. In that regard, it would be extremely important both for the boards and for the panels themselves to see how they want to conduct the discussion with the community. Because it's essential that the input and the discussion is being made by the community and not only by a five or six-person panel. In that regard, the question that is asked, which is near-term efforts and long-term perspectives, it is clear that it's probably less in the context of the NCSG and more in the context of the contracted party house, that part of the restructuring is going to take place in terms of forming new interest groups, forming observatory groups, and so on. However, the question you raise is a very interesting one regarding the balance between the different structures. The current structure of the GNSO is based on this balancing structuring of the two houses. However, if there's a huge number of actors on one side and not more actors on the other side, it may have an optical challenge in that regard. The ICANN model of review has functioned on a structure by structure. And in many cases, it was difficult to change things in one structure because it would have an impact on another. We have reached, I think, a moment, or at least I sense that growing understanding, that we have reached a moment where the creation of the new GTLD program is actually bringing back on ICANN an obligation to adapt to the new environment that it creates. And I think the period that is opening up now, precisely with this panel and the discussions that will go around, is the right moment to ask and to participate in those discussions.
Some of the discussions we have been having in the board are around silos and the perception that, you know, we're getting a lot of silos in ICANN, and the effect of that is that each silo gives its report to the board and asks the board to sort out the differences between the silos. And I'm keen to understand whether one of the big reforms or supposed reforms, because I think it already existed anyway, was creating working groups or more use of working groups in the GNSO. And I'm just wondering if that's working and how we can help make that more effective.
I did want to point out, though, in terms of the near term, one of the things that I would say is that we have to sort of stabilize and make fair the current situation while we're talking about the long-term situation. And that's the point I made about the MPOC and NOMCOM. I think in terms of working groups, yes, they do appear to be working. We do appear, but we had a conversation with GAC this morning in NCUC where we pointed out that, you know, you have junior folks in your ministries. Why aren't they participating in our working groups? So, and those are the paths that I would take. But that's a longer conversation that I'd love to engage with you, because, you know, I've got an amazing number of ideas, as do the rest of the members of NCSG.
So I follow up on what Bruce said and Maria, and very much the same question. It's not in the sense, man, that, you know, I want to have the answers from you, but I think it's important at this stage where we are. Because so many things are changing, so many, you know, new developments we see arising, don't automatically lead to the question that certain configuration have to move up, and new studies have to emerge. So that's why I think it's relevant to get, you know, the most top important and relevant points, you know, you actually would love to raise with us. Because otherwise we just turn around, you know, we give you some ideas, we come back to some, and then the process becomes a bit very long. So this would be very much appreciated.
Thank you. I think we're always ready to talk with you some more.
I'm not just talking.
I don't.
Shut up. Go ahead.
I was just going to say that, I spoke this morning to the fellows, and every time I do, the thing I have to spend a lot of time on is explaining to them what the hell's the difference between NCUC and Papanalak, and why is society in ICANN broken up in this way, and how am I supposed to decide where to go, and what is the relative merits of this, and I spend an enormous amount of time laying out the different structures and their pros and they serve different functions, all that, and it just, at the end of the day, there's such a mind-boggling drain on our collective energies.
Thank you, Aubrey. My name is Remy, again. Looking at the mental process of ICANN in terms of our inclusiveness, over the years, we have come to realize that we are not seeing the new batch of faces that we expect when it comes to multi-stakeholder build-up. So I would like to find out, probably from the board, what they're doing in terms of shaping this, because you discover over time that a kind of a group of people that keep on circulating, and if this group of people happens to move or decide to step aside, we're going to have problems in terms of structure base in carrying on the activities of some of these constituencies, just like some people have already alluded. We need to make sure that the multi-stakeholder model of ICANN is sustained and not drift away, kind of. Thank you.